Well, a quick hello to our friend Tim Suttert of Classic Motorsports Magazine, the publisher there. Thank you for the t-shirt, Tim. This is Jamal of Cooper Road Mini. Let's do a quick update on our. We've got the box open here right before us. Our Mini Moke transmission and other goings on around the Cooper Road Mini basement. This is kind of a rare look at the things I can just sort of leave laying around for weeks as I contemplate these projects. There's probably three or four gearbox bits and pieces here. Parts from the three synchro. Parts from the original Moke would have been the three synchro. Parts from the destroyed four synchro that we built with the magic wand. Parts from a rod change that I'm going to build as a backup for my own green Cooper Road Mini, the 66 Cooper S. There's our parts tank with, again, just a plethora of transmissions. What we've got going on here, we're going to take a quick look at our modification. We're going to use a three synchro first second shift fork. I talked briefly about this in a previous little chat, but this is the I think it's 22A611 part number. That's the what's called for the three synchro boxes. Actually, I pulled this one out of the Moke gearbox. You can kind of sneak this lower shift rod out and pull the lower shift fork through the diff opening without disassembling the gear set. So this thing's just in really nice shape. I'll show the way it fits the gear selector slider in another short clip here. But what I've done here is we've made the modification. It's pretty easy to see. You can see right in here we've got to take a little bit off this to clear the reverse fork, as it were, set screw and lock nut, jam nut. So let me try to knock this into second gear. And we can see right there how we're just sort of having to end up pushing it over a little bit. See if I can point to, we did some cutting in here on the shift fork, but we can see how it's just hitting the set screw for the reverse fork. And you can kind of move it around, you can tell that you're right on right there. So we need to pull that out and do a little bit more. I found a nice way of making this come out. You can really see the movement. And I'll hold this very still. See, as I pull it back into neutral, it kind of rolls off that set screw, so we have some interference there. Here's the other area here. We modified the end of the shift fork, where when it goes in towards second gear, if it's left as it is, it'll hit the case in the four synchro application. But what we've done is some very careful trimming here. We can see, it's hard to see, but right there we've got enough clearance. That's as far forward as we need to go here. And we can see that we've only taken a small bit off of there. And we can really see the difference when we compare the standard four synchro unit, the 22G889, I believe, which is very expensive and hard to find now. And in every way I can see, the three synchro modified like this is beefier and stronger and should result in much more positive first second shift, especially with our magic wand setup we're grafting onto here. All right, we'll be back with more.